The murder of a 69-year-old disabled passenger from New York City angers America. After a 72-hour siege at sea, negotiations among the PLO, Italy, and Egypt succeed in getting the Achille Lauro back to Egypt. There, the four terrorists surrender the ship. At first, the world is led to believe that no one is harmed, so the Palestinians are promised safe passage out of Egypt. But the next day, the truth is learned, and the U.S. ambassador to Egypt makes the announcement. The murder of a 69-year-old disabled passenger from New York City angers America. Americans are outraged when the terrorists are allowed to escape on an Egyptian plane to safe territory in Tunisia. This time, Reagan takes action.
What we want is justice done.
In a flawless execution, U.S. Navy F-14 fighter jets intercept the Egyptian airliner in midair and force it to land at a U.S. base in Sicily.
These young Americans sent a message to terrorists everywhere. A message, you can run, but you can't hide.
Italian courts convict the Palestinian hijackers. But again, the Reagan administration and the public are left dismayed when Italian authorities grant freedom to Abul Abbas, the man believed to be the brains behind the hijacking. Italian courts had found no direct evidence of his involvement.